just like a Nancy Myers movie.
She's our favorite director.
I love You've Got Mail.
That's Nora Ephron, you idiot.
I know.
Wait, hold up. Planning a wedding like that in 14 hours...
Who wants Nancy Myers, right?
...challenge in history.
I have no idea.
How are you gonna do it?
I was kinda hoping you would.
Thought I was supposed to get you guys the wedding present.
Of course I will.
That's my girl.
All right, listen up, people. The next 14 hours...
El Shmoo.
But in the end, you will have the satisfaction of knowing that you've finally done something worthwhile with your lives.
I kinda think the police were...
I don't have time to stroke your damn ego, Sergeant. Let's make a wedding.
Of course, anything. Except killing someone. Or maiming someone. Or breaking the law in any way. Or duty. Also, I don't like waking up super early in the morning. You know, why don't you just tell me what you want?
Cool. I need to go to Newstetter, New York. I gotta pick up a pair of ruby earrings I pawned before I went into hiding.
You said 6 hours away. I'm not so sure we can get there back in time.
Jake, there's no wedding without the earrings. My grandmother wore them on her wedding day and said they blessed her union. Do you want this union to be blessed, Jake? Or do you want this union to be friggin' unblessed?
Blessed. Totally blessed. I'll do it. It's fine. But I should warn you, my car is a piece of junk and it's always breaking down.
Ah, come on. The universe isn't gonna let anything bad happen to two best friends.
Unless we're in a fiery crash and our bodies are burned beyond recognition.
Ooh, Gina's got jelly beans.
Pimento? No. Bad.
Sorry, Gina.
That was amazing. He actually listens to you. Hey, you should come with us on this trip. You know, in case he starts acting...
Bat crap, Looney Tunes?
Yes, you can use your powers to keep him in check.
Yeah, people fear me. The only reason I'm not your boss right now is because I'd hate to do that to Holt, being mean sis.
And also, you're not a cop.
Well, you're not the basis of a character on Empire, Jake, but I don't throw that in your face every damn day.
So you will come with us?
Yeah, I'll be there.
You the man.
Bye, girl.
See you in the car, girl.
Okay, first, the good news. I generated a detailed timeline broken down to 30-second increments to keep us on track. Bad news, we're already 16.5 increments behind schedule.
Oh, man, Terry feels overwhelmed.
Good, use it. Neil Armstrong was overwhelmed when he walked on the moon, but you know what he did? He walked
on the
moon. Charles, you're in charge of food.
I've been planning a nuptial menu since the day I met Genevieve. Warning, it will be delicious and highly erotic.
Your menu is not going to involve animal genitalia, is it?
No, I was going to make... not that.
Terry, you're on hair and makeup. I've seen your little girl's pigtails, so I know you can do it.
They actually prefer my hair work to their mommy's. I love their little heads.
Terry, what's going on, man?
It's just a matter of time before I'm doing their hair at their weddings. It goes so fast. They're still babies.
Pull it together, Jeffords. Scully and Hitchcock, you're in charge of seating.
Smart move, Amy. I've been called the Leonardo da Vinci of sitting on my ass.
Great. And, Captain, you can help me decorate.
I'm at your disposal. Just tell me what to do. I'm here to implement your vision.
Oh. We just want to keep it classy.
Got it. Balloon arch.
What?
Say no more. It's done. I'm off to the nearest balloon store.
Okay. Rosa, you go to the office, have a couple Bellinis, and just relax.
It's a Bellini.
Peach juice and champagne.
Peach juice and champagne. What am I, six?
Oh, come on. Just try it. It's what Nancy Myers would drink.
Fine. For Nancy.
So, big day. How you feeling, buddy?
Good. Giddy. Never felt giddy before.
Didn't realize how close it was to hungry.
No, it's possible you were just hungry. When's the last time you ate?
3 days ago.
You excited for being married?
Yeah. I love Rosa. I can't wait to just jam my tongue in her ear holes and eat the hair off her head. Ooh, I'm giddy.
Oh, that's cute.
All right, we're looking for 381 Smith Street. It should be up here. Hopefully they still have your earrings.
You sure we're looking for 381? Because 381's looking a little crisp.
Oh, no, it burned down. How did this happen?
It's okay. Everything's gonna be fine. We'll think of something, all right?
Nope. This is a sign from the universe. I can't marry Rosa. Guys, what is all this?
Oh, no!
That's it! We're getting married! This is a disaster.
Come on, I mean, they're just earrings, right?
Can we get another pair?
Or we can make some new ones. All we need is like a blacksmith.
What store do you want to go to?
A smelter.
Is
a smelter.
Like
that can't be right.
What places are close to here that have clothes?
The universe is sending me a sign. And when the universe talks,
I don't know, like, you could go, like, the designer stores, I guess, and bring me back something. You get me, like, a Versace shirt.
I'm not talking to you, I'm talking
to you. Well,
maybe, yeah.
You're right, the marriage
is
closed.
I don't know if
it's wrong. No, you waited wrong.
I'm sorry, Jake, it's an omen. I'm not taking your side against the universe if it's hundreds of years old.
What if there was something the universe that could prove to you that you should still get married? What would that be?
Finding its grandma's earrings. Or we could cut Rose's ears off, and then it's like the earrings don't even make sense.
Thank you! Someone's trying to help.
Okay, so the earrings. Maybe somebody bought them before the place burned down, right? We could track them
chair's coming, guys.
Shh, we're working.
That sounds good.
Okay, so we'll go with that one?
No, I said it was good. I didn't say it was right.
Wow, taking this really seriously.
Amy, will you taste this batter?
Mm-hmm. I think it's a little off.
You know what's off? Your mouth. Why Jake lets your stupid tongue anywhere near him, I'll never know.
Nope, I forgot the sugar. That's on me.
Whoa, you really made the balloon arch.
Me? No, I birthed her. There's no form more graceful than the arch. No object more whimsical than the balloon.
Yes, you and I think that, but what will Rosa think?
Good point. Rosa would want a much, much bigger balloon arch. Back to the balloon store.
Amy, we've got a problem.